What's going on, YouTube? Michael here. Today I'm going to be unboxing my brand new InMotion V11. I am excited. Let's open it up and let's see what we have inside. Alright guys, I just got this box off. Let's see what else we got here. Whew, look at that. Oops. But now you have this beautiful box here. This right here to me represents finishing and packaging. And that is a good sign that the product has been, you know, well reviewed, or you know, they just took time to finish up on the product. So we're gonna take the time and just get this out of the box and see what we have inside. Okay. All right, guys. So this here is the pump, InMotion, as you can see, and this comes with the InMotion unicycle. So I'm just gonna use this to air up my suspensions, and that's why they have. That's why we have them. All right, what's the next thing? All right, I got some tools, baby. And yeah, instructions and tools. Get to the side. What do we have here? In here we have the charger. And the electric unicycle. I guess it comes with the regular charger, not the fast charger. See that? Okay. Put that to the side. Wow, just look at that. Isn't this just beautiful? To do is to air up the suspensions, and if you look right here, it says that depending on how heavy you are, that is how much air you're gonna put into it. So for my weight group, I'm gonna probably put in 130 psi, and you put the air in the in this tube. There's one here, there's another one on the other side. And then when you finish with that, you need to take these off and put air in on the other side. So let's see how difficult or easy that will be, and stay tuned. I'm gonna put in 130 PSI. Okay. And remember, we're going for 130 PSI. We're at 50 PSI. And we are at 130 PSI. All right. Plug this chamber back up. All right, guys, the next thing I'm gonna have to do is to take off these two screws and these two screws on both sides. So we got two here and two on the back. So I need to do these for basically each side. You know, we got one screw here on this side, one on the other side, one here,
one and the other side. And I'm gonna have to do that on both sides so that I can air up the negative chamber in there.
So we successfully took off all the screws, so this should pop right up. Take out the other side as well. Sucker up. Now, how much air do I need to put in here? Let me find out. To 50 PSI.
Just want to have 50 PSI in here.
Let's see. It does not take long at all. This took like 5 seconds, and I'm at 50. I'm gonna go a little bit above because you lose some air when you pull off the. Yep. Do the same thing on the other side. All right, I'm gonna turn this around. Okay. Close this chamber back up. Actually have to close the pedals to put the side back on. So I already downloaded the app. It's called InMotion, and you can always scan the barcode and the handbook. That's gonna link you to the site where you can download the InMotion app, or you could just Google it. And yeah, so next thing I'm gonna do is this is the app. Now I'm going to try and find this device. So first I'm going to turn this on. Oh, wow. So this comes in transport mode, so it doesn't like self-balance itself.
Please activate your beagle.
Wow. That sounds like...
Please activate your beagle.
Sounds like RoboCop's girlfriend right now.
Please activate your beagle.
All right, so let's search again.
Please okay. Activate
Beagle. As you can see, I just found this device. And it's connected to it. Okay guys, so this wheel is unlocked, so it's time to get on it and see what the suspension feels like for the first time. So. Thank you for watching this video. This wheel has been super impressive to me. I can say that the clearance for the pedal is 10 inches high, and that is remarkably impressive because that means that if you're riding on the trail, you have less chances of clipping your pedal. The mud guard at the back is impressive as well. You know, it's gonna keep the mud from getting on your back while you ride if you're riding in the mud or in a wet environment. Also, the lights are impressive. It looks, you know, just like high performance. I haven't taken it on a road test yet, but the suspensions do feel a little bit different. Feels like jumping on a spring mattress. The side panels feel a bit like, you know, soft. I don't know how much resistance they have if you get in a crash, but in the meantime, I'm just gonna plug this in to charge. Thank you for watching this video. If you haven't subscribed by now, hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, drop a comment. Let me know if you had troubles unlocking your wheel like I do, and like I did. And let me know if, you know, just generally what you think about this wheel. I would like to hear in the comment section, let me know what you think about this wheel in one word. Drop it in the comment section. And I'll talk to you on there. And until next time, peace.